It's Motivation Monday time. It is Sunday. It's a beautiful day in Los Angeles. And some people don't have the money or the time or the resources, even though, you probably would have the resources, but maybe not the money or the time to go on a real vacation. So I have five ideas for you, five tips on how you can have a blast and make the most of a staycation. A staycation. When was the last time you read? I feel I'm always busy, so I hardly ever take the time to read because I'm always busy on my computer. So take a day or just a few hours and really put all your stuff away, your computer, your phones, and just really dive into a book that you've been wanting to read, or use Kindle. I have my Kindle Cloud Reader, so I actually read books on my computer as well. But just like spend a few hours just really just indulging, reading, and getting lost in a book. When was the last time you did that? It's been a while since I did that. Explore your town. There must be a museum or an exhibition, an art show, something, or maybe a specific hike that you haven't gone on, or even just downtown, a cool building, something historic in your town. Go and see that. Like, become a tourist in your own town. I've been living in LA for a long time, and there's still been things that I haven't done. And when my mom came to visit, we actually went up to the Hollywood sign, and I've gone other places where I kind of took a picture and I saw it, but I have not gone to that specific park I went to. So it's so much fun, and you become like a tourist in your own town, and you're gonna learn something new about your town, or you can finally say, hey, I finally went there. Like, if you live in New York, maybe you never went to the Empire State Building, right? So do that. That's so much fun. So this may sound a little bit crazy, but try it. Make a list of about 10 places you would really love to go visit someday. And go on YouTube and watch some videos about it so that you kind of feel like you are being there. And then in the future, you can really go there and see how it really is versus the video you saw. But just by watching the video, you're doing a little getaway in your mind and you're visualizing and eventually materializing that trip. So that's another really cool way to kind of get away even if you're not really leaving. Join a yoga class or a dance class just for a few lessons, just to meet new people and to do something you haven't done but maybe you always wanted to do and you didn't get a chance to do because you're always busy.
Spend a day at the pool, wherever you are. Maybe your friends have a pool, maybe you have a pool. I have a pool at my apartment building. I'm at a friend's house right now. And just chill out. Swim, relax, make yourself a drink, get some water, maybe some ice cream, and really spoil yourself a little bit. And imagine when you're swimming, close your eyes and imagine you're on your favorite island or your favorite hotel. It's so relaxing and it's so rejuvenating. Or you could also go to the beach, of course.
This is one of my favorites. Two options. Either, if you're on a tight budget, just go and have a nice cappuccino in a nice cafe where you can really get a chance to people watch. And if you are not on a super tight budget, go to a really nice restaurant, possibly also that has like an outdoor patio where you can really sit and people watch, you know, get a chance to maybe stir up some conversations with people and really treat yourself to a nice dinner, maybe even dessert and a cappuccino. And really treat yourself. Take that time, take the hour and a half, 2 hours by yourself and have a nice dinner by yourself. And if you really hate being by yourself, then invite a friend. But I encourage you to really do it by yourself and sit by yourself and just really be in the moment and appreciate all the little things. Before you eat your food, right? Look at your food and go like, whoa, that looks so delicious. And when you're eating your food, really savor the taste, savor every bite of it. Really enjoy it. When you're getting a cappuccino and they make it really like the traditional beautiful flower leaves or like a heart on it, whatever it is, really enjoy it. Take a little picture of it and put it on your Instagram and go like, yay, go to me. I'm really treating myself. I'm enjoying myself.
So I really hope that these few tips will help you
Have a great staycation. And if you have any other suggestions in the comment section below, let us know. What have you done on your staycation? What are your suggestions on how to have a blast even though you're not leaving town or you're not leaving your country? There's so much you can do to really have fun and enjoy yourself and relax and rejuvenate, which is so important. I mean, check out these two guys, right? I hope you have an amazing week. I will post another podcast interview on Wednesday. And until then, stay put. And there will also be more music coming in July because it's July 1st. It's my birthday month. Yes, I will release a lot of music this month because it's all been waiting. And I haven't really gotten a chance to do it, but this month I will do it. Hold me accountable. I love you guys so much, and I will talk to you later. And there's one more thing I want to say. Thank you so much for watching my podcasts and for listening to the podcast. I would love to have you on as my guest. My whole intention for the podcast really is to bring people together. We are so much more alike than we are different, and I really want to bring people together through their stories that are very relatable, hopefully very inspiring, and also let you know that, hey, I'm not alone in this. I can reach out to this person. I have similar issues, and maybe we can help each other. That is so important. If you would like to be on my podcast, The Stories That Bind Us, which is available on Spotify, on Google Podcasts, there's a whole list. I will put the link below, but on anchor.com, it will show you actually where all the other podcasts are available. And I just really would love to have you on my show if you're interested and share your story. It doesn't matter where you are, where you've been, or where you want to go. It's about the now. What have you learned in your life? What would you like to do that you haven't done yet? And share that with the rest of the community and see who can help you, who you can help, who you may empower to finally speak that truth and say, hey, you know what? I've gone through this too. And by the way, I need to show you these awesome palm trees that I love so much. I really love palm trees. Anyway, thank you so much for listening and watching to my podcast. I would love to have you on. And I will talk to you very soon, guys, on Wednesday with another episode of The Stories That Bind Us. And I promise in July, I will share more music. It's all waiting to be finished. I just haven't really had a chance to put quality time into that. But I will do that in July because it's my birthday month. Yay! I'll talk to you soon. Bye.